If you know the work of our guest today, Richard Butler, it is probably through his influential 80s band, the Psychedelic Furs, or Love Spit Love, his band from the 90s, because his new self-titled solo project is his first. It comes at a time of considerable upheaval in Richard's life, including the dissolution of his marriage and the death of his father. The Cafe's Dan Reed finds out how those events bear on the work. Starts off by asking Richard if throughout his career as a band leader, he had ever thought of a solo album before.
Yeah, I thought about it a few times, actually. I thought about it around the time of Forever Now was when I first wanted to do one, and then, you know, just put the shelved that for a while. I was talked out of it, shelved it, and then when I took a break from the band, from the Furs, I started writing with Richard Fortus and a couple of friends, my brother Tim, and for what became Love Spit Love. But those songs were written in such a way that it sounded very much like a band. It didn't sound like a solo record. And so that could have been a solo record, but wasn't, you know, because it was the... But when it came to working with John, Karen, this time around, it was very much about, you know, the vocals were way out front, the lyrics were very obvious, you know, obviously about my life, and it seemed like, hey, this sounds like a solo record, and so that's how I decided to make this one.
I was really wondering how you felt the Psychedelic Furs sort of fit into the pantheon of rock history.
Well, it varies, you know. I mean, in the 90s, probably didn't fit quite so well. Now we fit really well because there's all those bands that sound like they're from the 80s anyway. It varies what's going on, but yeah. No, I think we fit pretty well. Where exactly, I don't know.
Well, that's the question. I mean, a lot of you, I read a quote somewhere that I thought it's quite a compliment, actually. You are the missing link between the Sex Pistols and Nirvana. And that's,
yeah, I said that.
You said that. Oh, okay.
No, it wasn't really. No.
It's a good quote, though.
No, it wasn't mine.
When you hear those kind of things, though, I mean, is it hard being a part of it to put it in perspective and what you've meant to listeners over the years? I know you've got a big fan base. I know you're very active in communicating with your fans throughout the years.
Yeah.
But what, I mean, is it still rewarding for you to hear from people and know,
oh, yeah,
know what your music's
but
meant
it's
to
always,
them?
I'm not egotistical kind of person, so I never think any sort of big thoughts about what we've done or what I've done, but it's always nice when, you know, people come up and say, oh, your music's meant so much to me, and, you know, people say, I got married to your music, and I'm, you know, what are you, crazy? But it's always very sweet that it's meant something to them, you know.
I saw the last year the Psychedelic Furs play, and believe it or not, through all the years of me being a fan, it's the first time I had seen the Furs play live. And man, you just look like you were just having a blast. It was here in Philadelphia.
Mm.
Just having a blast on stage with the guys now. Do you think that time has made it, made you appreciate being in that band and being part of that?
I think what made me appreciate being in the Furs was the time we took off, actually. From about, not, we didn't, we, 10 years we took off. I decided I'd had enough. I'd been doing it for 10 years and, you know, it wasn't exciting anymore, and it was kind of becoming a bit rote, and I just needed a break from it. And then, you know, we got back together and realized that it was fun doing it, and the songs were great songs to play, and nobody played them better than we did. And it was just great to be out there, you know? So yeah, in short, I do have a great time.
And speaking of the Psychedelic Furs, you're going to start off with a favorite of a lot of folks.
Love My Way.
Yeah. Richard Butler live.
Dance floor, it's a fashion with a gun, my love. In a room without a door, a kiss is not enough. In Love My Way, it's a new make us pay. But laughing in their faces and making it away, there's emptiness behind their eyes, it's dust in all their hearts. They just want to steal us all and take us all apart, but not in love my way. It's a new road I follow where my mind goes. Love my way, it's a new road I follow where my mind goes. You can never win or lose if you don't run the race. Yeah.
We're live with Richard Butler on the World Cafe. You've lived in America, actually in upstate New York, for several years now.
Yeah. I've been upstate for about 8 years since my daughter was born.
Okay. You lived in the city for a while? Yeah.
Yeah, since about 1981 I lived in New York.
Wow. It's been your permanent home.
Yeah.
Do you feel American, Richard?
No, but I don't feel English either, which is a nice position to be in. I kind of like it, you know, man without a flag.
So living here in the States hasn't really changed your point of view of where you're from or where you're going?
No, not really. No, I'm pretty much like an island, I suppose, you know, drifting around from one place to the other. But no, it never affects who I am. You know, you can never get rid of really where you come from, what it made of you. You're always going to be Richard Butler, this English bloke, wherever you live.
Right. I wanted to talk a bit about, you're also a painter.
Yeah.
And I love to talk to artists about, you know, those who do more than one thing, what the different experiences are. It's got to be different, but if you could explain how is it different coming up with a great song and having that feeling, or performing live perhaps, and finishing maybe a painting you'd been working on for a long time and you finally nailed it and you feel like you have it. What are the visceral differences in those experiences as an artist?
Well, there aren't really any differences in actually just making it. I mean, because basically you're coming from... All you're trying to do is you're coming from a feeling and you're translating that feeling either through words or through paint and onto like a canvas or a song. And then at the end of the day, if you've been successful when you listen to the song, it makes you feel what you felt originally. And if you're looking at a painting, it makes you feel what you felt originally. I guess the difference is, though, when you're in a band and you go out and play on stage, that's a very, very different feeling. That's, you know, there's a, you know, incredible excitement about it and an adrenaline rush, and that's unrepeatable. But that's playing live. That's not actually the creation of a song, you know. But, you know, live performance is nothing really like that.
Speaking of live performances, you're out on this tour now with, you want to introduce your bandmates here today?
Zach and Josh.
Zach and George playing guitar. And I believe this is a tune, you're going to play a tune now from your new album, the self-titled album from Richard Butler.
And Satellites.
This is Satellites on the World Cafe.
Under the satellites, you're on your own. And it's the same sad song all of us know. And he said, I'm not the man I used to be. I've heard a million lies, I still believe. I should save my breath, I should bite my tongue. 'Cause the same sun shines on everyone. I should in the scenery, I'm coming undone. I want every minute back now that they've gone. I should save my breath, I should bite my tongue. 'Cause the same sun shines on everyone. I should bite my lip, let my big mouth sleep. 'Cause the whole damn world don't turn on me. I'm not the same as I used to be. One of a million lies I still believe.
That was Satellites, a tune that appears on the very first Richard Butler solo album. I've read a lot of the interviews about this new album, and I know that you went through some pretty big life-changing events in your own personal life, and you say that really informed this album. the word I got out of it listening to it several times is it's contemplative. Would you say that's a fair assessment?
Oh, yeah, very much. I thought you were going to say depressing, which it isn't entirely.
No, it isn't. That's my point is, you know, it's like it may seem so somewhere on the surface here and there, but it's actually more just taking stock to where you are now today.
Yeah, oh, yeah. And, you know, you could... Or a couple of people have made a big deal about, you know, that I've been through some changes in my life and they've informed the album and how sad that is. But it's not that sad. I mean, it's nothing, there's nothing that's on the record that everybody doesn't go through, you know, sooner or later. So it's not that awful. It's just part of life, really.
The lyrical content, you know, the other part of this is, you know, it just seems like, as we talked earlier about, you know, you taking stock of where you are today, and boy, nothing beats just the mere act of getting older to give you some different frames of references.
Oh, yeah, that's the truth. Bit of perspective.
Yes,
yeah.
Perspective is the word. Yeah.
Yeah, having my daughter as well just made an enormous change in my life. You know, a massive change.
And what's the biggest change? Would you say?
Well, about having
having children. Yes.
Well, for one thing, it's in a weird way a yardstick that you measure your own time going by. I mean, when you don't have a daughter, say, or a son, you know, you look vaguely the same every year. You get a little bit older, there's a few lines here or there, but you don't really notice the passing of time that much. But when you've got, you know, somebody who's like 2 foot tall 1 week and it seems like they're 4 foot tall a week later, you know, not literally, but you notice how quickly time's going by, you know, and you sort of measure your life against this sort of weird little yardstick that's zipping up,
keeps growing.
And the other thing is, it's you know, bizarre. Much as you know you love a girlfriend or boyfriend in your life or whatever, it's a different kind of love that you have for a daughter, you know, and or a son, and it's, you know, somebody that without any doubt you would absolutely throw yourself in front of a car to push him out of the way. And unfortunately, maybe it's just me, but with relationships it's always been, would I really do that? I don't know.
Richard Butler. Thanks to Richard and Dan Reed for a great interview today. If you're looking for the new album, just call it Richard Butler. You can find it at our World Cafe CD store, on your web browser at worldcafe.npr.org.